Peter Quill, Chris Pratt, is from Earth and is now, as an adult, been raised by space pirates. Now, however, on his own, he decides to steal this orb thingy that's worth a lot of money. However, in the process of trying to sell said orb and avoiding all the other interested parties that want what's inside the orb, Peter Quill must team up with Drax, Gamora, Root, Groot, sorry mate, and Rocket in order to stop Ronan, who wants what's inside the orb so that Thanos will destroy a planet for him. Quill and his new friends must do something in order to stop Ronan and his evil plan. Is this movie super awesome like I remember? Let's find out. Oh my gosh, this movie was so not awesome. It was super duper frickin' awesome. That's what it was. Let us start with the soundtrack, guys. The soundtrack is so frickin' awesome. I mean, it's the type of soundtrack that's like pop culture soundtrack from the 70s, 80s. The type of music that a kid would listen to when he was remembering his mother growing up with her in the 70s and 80s. It is magnificent. It's awesome. It has such classics as Hooked on a Feeling by Blue Swede, Fooled Around and Fell in Love by Elvin Bishop, and one of my most favorite songs, I Want You Back by the Jackson 5, and so much more pop culture hit songs in it. For me, when a movie decides to put real pop culture songs in a movie, it can either break or make it. In this case, man, did it ever make it. Let's look at the acting next. Chris Pratt, amazing. I loved him in Parks and Rec before this, and I love him now. He does an amazing job. He's an amazing actor, and he pulls it off as Star-Lord. I can't honestly at this point imagine any other Star-Lord. Dave Bautista is another actor that's notable. His acting's flat enough to, I believe, James Gunn was able to use that, and the writers able to use that to make it to where it comes off really good, like a brute, a dumb brute, that's honor-bound and believes in honor and stuff, but overconfident about his own intelligence. It really makes it really funny. Whatever they did, great job with him as well. Rocket, a little raccoon, a CGI character, was so good and so well voiced by Bradley Cooper imitating Jason Alexander. Don't you think that seems like it? It seems like he sounds like Jason Alexander to me. Leave a comment if you guys think that's true. He does such a good job that I forget he's not a real character. I forgot that he was CGI. I was like, that's a real emotion coming from this creature. That is crazy. This movie really highlights a tool that is so important and so relevant to today. It is the theme of uniting over a common enemy, problem, or beneficial goal. And that's what happens in this movie. They focus on their similarities. They focus on their common goals. Focusing on their differences on a superficial level, kind of, but kind of dismiss, hey man, you're part of the group, we're part of the group, we work together. Not really a focus, their differences. Focusing on common goals, being willing to sacrifice for the group, and not focusing on all of your differences, creates a strong, united force, able to deal with any issue and any said goal. Any enemy of the group would love you to focus on all of your differences so you'll be divided. Focus on the similarities, not the differences. That's what I learned in this movie today. In summary, this movie is really great. It's got some really funny moments in it, followed by some sad moments, followed through some, are they gonna make it moments. It is just a wonderful movie. Not to mention, this movie has some great space battles. It didn't even occur to me that MCU would be going into outer space until this one. I was like, oh my gosh, we're going into outer space? That's crazy! Hulk in space? What? That always seems awesome to me. And that's why I have to give Guardians of the Galaxy, I just got to, guys. I got to give it a 10 out of 10 on this one. 10 out of 10. It's awesome. I love it. It's just as good as when I saw it the first day. But hey, guys, you don't have to stop watching videos. Now, there's a video MCU playlist right up there you can choose right there. Continue learning from videos, documentaries, and TV. Better tools of living. Or you can pick a random video right there. Either way, you don't have to stop here.